Guys like Eddie O does a great job on NBC. Crisscross the country, but still, it's for the love of the sport, Eddie. It's Don LaGreca and Dave Rothenberg. How are you, buddy?
I'm doing well, Donnie. Dave, good morning to you guys. I should say good afternoon. I had the early flight out of Newark this morning, so I got to L.A. about 10 o'clock this morning, so I think it's still morning for me, but good day to both of you.
Nope, you got 12:30, so you're okay. You're in the afternoon.
All right.
Henrik Lundqvist stole a game, and...
Yeah.
You know, you look at the third periods of this series, and I took out Game 3 because the Kings had a 3-0 lead going into the third period. But the other three third periods, the Rangers have been outshot 47-11 and outscored 2-0. Can the Rangers win Game 5 on Friday if they do not possess a lead going into the third period?
Well, I think there's always the possibility when you have the guy in goal that the Rangers have. And, Donnie, we've talked over the years, and I think you know my thoughts on Henrik Lundqvist of being one of the top three goaltenders in our league and has been the franchise for the Rangers for a long, long time. So when you have that going for you, anything is possible. But, you know, they got to give him a breather. I mean, they got to find a way to play 200 feet away from him, not force him to be, you know, the only thing going good for them in the third periods. And look... The LA Kings are a much different animal than the Rangers have seen so far in these playoffs. The Kings, as everybody's seen and Ranger fans have seen now up close and personal for four straight games, is the Kings are a big team, they're a heavy team, they can really skate, and they wear on you. And the Rangers are not built to be a grinding, physical team. Yeah, they pick their spots. Yes, Ryan McDonough making some big hits, Dorsett making some big hits, Boyle, Kreider. But if they continue to do that for long stretches and long runs of games, they're going to get tired out. And I think that's what happened early in the series, where I think they were grinding and they were, you know, they were just, that's not the strength of the Rangers to be a grind team. And what I mean by that is playing below the goal line, you know, go one-on-one confrontations. The Rangers want to play a rush game, meaning going from their zone all the way through the middle of the ice, just like the goal they scored last night with Marty St. Louis. That's the type of game that they want to play. And you get tired out. It gets physically draining on you. So is there a way around it? Probably not. But I think that they have to find a way to possess the puck a lot better in the third periods, and if they want to stretch this thing back to the Garden for a Game 6.
Eddie, the Rangers led 2-0 last night. They clung to a 2-1 victory. We all know how great Lundqvist was.
Yeah.
I think it's vitally important. How important is it for the Rangers to get that first goal on Friday night and just at least seal some time with the lead and maybe set the tone a little bit and get a little bit of confidence that way? Because for me, if you fall behind, you could be pummeled on Friday night in LA.
I don't want to avoid answering it, Dave, but I guess I'll answer it this way. I think it's more important for the Rangers to score the first goal than it is for the LA Kings, for sure. We've seen what LA has done over and over and over again. They're never out of a game. But there is something for confidence. There is something for playing with the lead. And the Rangers have done, for the most part, I mean, they've done a pretty good job of playing with the lead for long stretches. Now, yeah, they've given up, what, 3 2-goal leads, you know, in the first, you know, what, 3 games in this series, or, you know, the first two in LA anyways. But you got to find a way to gut one out. You're going to have to weather the storm early and figure out a way to limit as many opportunities as you can. I think, you know, the easiest thing to say is, yeah, it's a Game 7 mindset. But the two games that come to mind for me is doing a lot of the Ranger games in these playoffs was Game 7 versus Philly and Game 6 versus Montreal.
Mm-hmm.
Those were as two good of games that I've seen of any team really check and defend. Now, the LA Kings are not the Philadelphia Flyers, and they're certainly not the Montreal Canadiens. I understand that, but you have to have that same mindset of being that good defensively, limit the opportunities, check until you're blue in the face, and figure out a way to stretch this series to one more game.
Talking to Eddie Olczyk from NBC. They will have the game coming up Friday as the Rangers try to stave off elimination for a second consecutive game. Eddie, you talk about puck possession, but how difficult is it to possess the puck when you're getting crushed on faceoffs? The Kings are as good as I've seen in the league at winning draws.
Yeah, well, that's that's one way that you you limit their puck possession is finding a way to win some faceoffs. And look, the centermen for the Rangers are up against it, and they're trying different things. You know, they're cheating as much as they can. They're tying up. They're trying to get some help. But you talk about the depth. You know, you had me on last night in the pregame show, Donnie. When you look at the center ice position, or at least how the Kings are built at the through the middle of the ice, in goal, on the back end at the center ice, there's no doubt the LA Kings are the deepest center ice club in the entire National Hockey League, 1 through 4. I mean, when you can throw out Kopitar, Carter, Stoll, and Richards as your 1, 2, 3, 4, I'd like an argument of who's better, 1 through 4. Now, if you want to say Pittsburgh with Malkin, Crosby, and Sutter, okay, well, you know, I can make an argument there. Zetterberg and Datsyuk, yeah, that's pretty darn good. Throw Darren Helm in there. You know, I would throw Detroit certainly up there in the top three or four. But it's you got to find a way to try different things. You got to get some help from your wingers and defensemen. It's always easy to blame the center iceman, but it is a team stat. If you ask any coach, it is a team stat, and the Rangers got to get some more help for their center iceman from their wingers and defensemen.
If you're the Rangers and you're Lane Vigneault or Lundqvist or anybody on this club, how much confidence do you take in the fact that every time your back has been to the wall in the postseason, you've answered the bell? I mean, you did it in a must-win against Philly. You did it 3 times against Pittsburgh. You've now done it in the Stanley Cup Final against the LA Kings. Is there that kind of feeling in the locker room that we continually avoid that, or is that just a one game, one shift, one time kind of attitude for the Rangers now?
Well, I think they can certainly hang their hat on that. I mean, this has been a resilient team. This team has overachieved without doubt this season. And whatever you've gone through as a player or as a coach most recently, you can certainly take and learn from that when it comes to what's the next game in front of you. And they've had their backs up against the wall without a doubt, and they've been able to respond. And again, I go back to the games. That game 7 against Philly, and then the game 6 against Montreal. I mean, that's the type of game I think that the Rangers have to play. And you know, this is a team that has lots of confidence. And you know, there is no tomorrow. But you got nothing to lose, really. I mean, you're up against it, and you got to go out there and play as loose as you can, play within the system as much as you can. But again, you got to get another bang-up game from Henrik Lundqvist, who was the first, second, and third star of that game last night, in my opinion, and you got to give him a little bit of help. And it's not going to be easy, and you got to be able to find a way to play those type of games on the road. But the Rangers have done it, and that's what they can take into tomorrow night's game. And let's not forget the games that they played here in L.A. as well.
Yeah.
Played pretty good games. I mean, they really did. They weren't able to get the knockout punch to get a 3-0 lead in either one of those games. They didn't get the call with the interference, well documented, with Dwight King on Henrik Lundqvist. There should have been a call. But they played pretty well here. So I think you can – not a lot of talking needs to be done, but I think Elaine Vigneault can certainly go to those type of stretches in games here in L.A. that they played really well and were able to dictate the terms that for a lot of stretches of the games in L.A.
Eddie, enjoy it tomorrow, and I think everybody hopes to see you Monday at Madison Square Garden.
All right, boys, I'm going to call the travel agent right now.
Yes, because
book that ticket.
Yeah, book it ahead of time, man. It's happening, all right?
Either way, I'm heading east. That's all I know.
All right. Enjoy it, buddy.
Thanks.